Hello student, I'm Mr. Leung. So in this video, we are going to talk about the chapter 16 assignment. It's about the coordination in humans. Just like as usual, this video will be divided into two parts. The first part will be the MC questions and the second part will be the long questions. And in this assignment, most likely we shall focus on the nervous system rather than the hormonal system. Because for the hormonal system, we shall discuss in depth, in details in chapter 18 is about the homeostasis. So that's why in this assignment, I shall focus on the nervous system first. So let's take a look in the MC question. So for question 2 is about a motor neuron. So as what you see in the diagram, you can see the cell body, nucleus, axon, and the myelin sheath. And then the question is that what is the function of the myelin sheath? So that's why we call the whole structure of the myelin sheath. And then one thing I would like to recall is that for the nerve cell, for the motor neuron, that means the nerve cell, it's just another term. So actually the neuron is responsible for transmitting the nerve impulse, and the nature of the nerve impulse is the electrical signal but not the chemical signal. So that's why for the answer A, B, C, D, apart from the verb, I want you to take a look at the chemical signal or electrical signal. So that's why for answers B and C, they are wrong already, because it's talking about insulate the chemical signal or reduce the loss of the signal from the chemical transmitter. So that's why B and C, they are not the answer. And then only answers A and D. So you can refer to the paragraph from the book, so you can see that we call the functions of the myelin sheath, okay, to protect and insulate the nerve fibers. And actually, what is the importance behind these two basic functions, okay? So is it the myelin sheath protecting the axon from the bacterial infection, or is it insulating the electrical signal passing along the neuron? So you tell me the answer. And then for question 6, it's talking about the story. A man left a glass of water from a table and then found it very hot. And then he then put the glass of the hot water back on the table. So from this story, I want you to identify if this action is voluntary or involuntary. Okay, it is very critical for this question, because for answers A and B, it's talking about is a reflex action, and for answers C and D, it's talking about this action is voluntary action. And then apart from whether it is voluntary or involuntary, for the other part is that I want you to identify the parts of the brain or the parts of the nervous system is involved in the actions. So that's why you can see the diagram on the bottom and also on the right hand side. So actually on the in the diagram of the right hand side is talking about the reflex action, and in the voluntary action there are two different pathways, pathway 1 and pathway 2. Okay, and then for the answer, I would like to have a brief idea first. Answers A and D, okay, they are wrong already. Okay, it's because it's talking about the part of the brain. Okay, is wrong. So for the first one, reflex action controlled by the cerebellum. Actually, the functions of the cerebellum is not talking about the reflex action. So that's why answer A is already wrong. And then for answer D, a voluntary action controlled by the medulla. And for the medulla oblongata, actually its function is also not controlling the voluntary action. So that's why answer A and D, they are already wrong. B is talking about the action is a reflex action controlled by the spinal cord. And then answer C is talking about this action is a voluntary action controlled by the cerebrum. So according to the story, okay, think about that, okay? Is it any analyze or interpretation process, okay, in this story? And then you can identify whether this action is voluntary or involuntary, and then you can determine the answer B or C, which one is correct. And then for question 8, the other story, okay, this is talking about a person. She accidentally touches a hot pan, so she can automatically withdraw the hand from the hot pan. Okay, so that's why the first question, you need to identify the nature of this action first. Is it voluntary or involuntary? You can see that this person, okay, she just accidentally touches the hot pan. So that's why she does not do the action intentionally, but accidentally, okay? So that's why it must be an involuntary action, right? And then for the other part, okay, in the question, the skills is that remember the good practice. The good practice is to name all the cells first, okay? Neuron P, Q, and R. Neuron P is the sensory neuron, neuron Q is the interneuron, and neuron R is the motor neuron. And actually, neurons P, Q, R is the reflex arc, okay, for the reflex action. So let's take a look at the question. So in an accident, the neuron R, motor neuron, was cut at the point labeled X. So how would this affect the person? Okay, so you can see that in the reflex arc PQR, okay, at this moment, neuron R was damaged, was cut. So what will happen? So for the guiding question and also for the diagram, you can see that receptor, sensory neuron, reflex center, and also to the motor neuron, and then to the effector. And then from the reflex center, we also have the interneuron to send the nerve impulse to the cerebrum to analyze what is the meaning of this nerve impulse detected or sent from the receptor. Okay, so that's why for the guiding question, I want you to think about that. Can the nerve impulse be transmitted from the receptor to the central nervous system? The first part. And the second question is that, can the nerve impulse be transmitted to the effectors from the central nervous system? And the third question is that, can the interneuron relay the nerve impulse among the neurons? That means among the between the sensory neuron and the motor neuron, okay? And also the interneuron to the cerebrum. So that's why for the reflex arc, okay, at least you must be able to know something first, because in this question it's only talking about the neuron R was cut. That means the motor neuron was cut, was damaged, right? And that means the sensory neuron and the interneuron, they are intact. They are not damaged. Okay, they are still good condition. So that's why for the ABCD, we need to think about that. For the answers A and B, it's saying that the stimulus would still be detected. And for answer C and D, is talking about the stimulus would not be detected. So that's why, because we see that neuron P is okay, that's why actually the nerve impulse can still be transmitted from the receptor to the CNS. So that's why for answer C and D, they must be wrong. Actually, A and B, either one of them is the answer. The stimulus would still be detected. And then the second question is talking about, so the muscle would contract or the muscle would not contract. So that's why you take a look at the motor neuron. Okay, well, I already mentioned in the neuron R already. So that's why for the motor neuron, if it is damaged, so can the nerve impulse be transmitted from the reflex center, that means from the central nervous system, to the effector? Yes or no, to be or not to be, that's the question. So for question 8, answers A or B, which one is the answer? You tell me. And then for question 10, okay, it's talking about which of the following comparisons about the voluntary action and the simple reflex action is incorrect. Read the question carefully. It's talking about incorrect. So that's why I give you these two diagrams. Okay, on the top right hand corner is the reflex action, and the diagram on the bottom, that's the voluntary action. And then for when we are comparing these two types of action, voluntary action and simple reflex action, the very first number one question we need to think about is that, recall whether the cerebrum is involved in the response. Okay, so is cerebellum involved in the voluntary action? Is cerebellum involved in the simple reflex action? That's the very first question you need to answer me first. And then for the following guiding question, is talking about is thinking process involved? Do we need to learn to perform such action? Or actually, once we are born, okay, we have the ability to perform this action. Is stimuli required, or same stimuli will need to the same response? Okay, so in this question, I give you the guiding question first. After you think about it, so you tell me which one is the incorrect comparison. And then for the question 11, that's the one question for the hormonal system. Which of the following is part of the hormonal system? So you can refer to the diagram, okay, you can refer the sentence. Endocrine glands are richly supplied with capillaries. The hormones produced by the endocrine gland diffuse directly into the blood because the blood, it can carry the hormones to our target organs. So that's why you can refer to the table, okay, on the bottom. The pancreas, okay, it will secrete some hormone to the blood, and then the blood will carry the hormones to the target organs. Okay, and the same case for the pituitary gland, thyroid gland, adrenal gland, and also for the ovaries and testes. So that's why you can see that answers B, C, D, they are wrong. But why A is correct? Okay, so you can see that option B is wrong because penis, it cannot produce sex hormone. Although you may think that penis actually is richly supplied with capillary. It cannot produce sex hormone. So that's why it is not a type of endocrine gland. And then for option C is wrong because salivary gland is an exocrine gland. It produces the saliva, and directly the saliva will be released to the mouth cavity for the digestion functions. And then for option D is also wrong because the prostate gland is also the exocrine gland. It can produce the prostate fluid, which is one of the components of the semen. So that's why the prostate gland is also directly released to the target organ, okay? Not go into the blood and then by the blood to be transferred to other target organs. So that's why option C, D, they are the exocrine gland. They are not one part of the hormonal system. And that's why only option A is correct. Ovaries can produce sex hormone for the development of the reproductive organs and also the secondary sexual characteristic. So that's why for option B, okay, penis is wrong because for the male, okay, actually the endocrine gland, okay, to secrete the sex hormone, it should be the testes but not the penis. So that's why is the question 11. If you have any question, so please leave it below. I will answer you as soon as possible, and then you can move on to the second part of the video to take a look at the long questions. See you next time. Bye bye.